Man finds glass in state park worth $250,000. It had been years of hope and then disappointment, but as he strolled along the rough pathways and dusty ridges, he saw something he had never seen before. It wasn't like the other baubles he'd gathered over his many visits, and soon he'd find out just how special it really was. Before we begin, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos. Upon first glance, Kevin Kennard of Maumelle, Arkansas, might have looked like your everyday sort of guy. He enjoyed traveling, spending time with his friends, and the occasional party or night out. However, the 33-year-old banker had a very interesting hobby that most people would never guess. It started in the second grade, a school field trip that had most kids rolling their eyes or scrunching their noses. Going to a state park wasn't anything to get excited over, but when his teacher told them what could be waiting for them and what they might be able to keep afterwards, the kids' interest skyrocketed. Ever since then, Kennard had made sure to go at least once a year to scratch his passionate itch. And even through the pandemic, he made sure his limited state travels included his ultimate hobby destination. So when Labor Day rolled around, he and a group of friends piled into a car. However, he had no idea that his next trip would change his life. As he breathed in the warm air laced with the scent of pine and earth, the group chose their plot and dropped their gear. But for some reason, Kennard didn't feel like going through the same motions they'd gone through for the past couple of decades. It was a break in tradition that would end up making him a fortune. Instead of stooping and sifting, Kennard grabbed his bag and slowly wandered the freshly plowed rows of the meager Acreage State Park. His heart would skip a beat any time he saw something out of the ordinary. There were a few glistening shards that held a sliver of promise, and since the park had a finder's keeper's policy, everything was fair game. The sun had dipped far past noon and Kennard's back was hurting from bending down so much. Maybe he should have used the traditional search method instead of just wandering. However, out of the corner of his eye, the light caught something he'd never seen before. It was dark, rough, and about the size of a large pea, but there was an interesting luminosity that made it quite lovely. The crazy thing was, it didn't spike his adrenaline like other times he'd made a hopeful discovery. It was probably just a piece of old glass. He shoved it in the little bag with the other finds and nearly forgot about it. Thankfully, his friend stepped in at the last minute. It was common practice for everyone in the park to take their hauls to the main office and have an expert inspect to see if there was anything of value. The rest of the group pushed Kennard to do the same. The inspect was free, after all. He shrugged and dumped his stones onto the counter. The employee's attention went to the dark stone, and his eyes turned as huge as dinner plates. The man grabbed the stone and ran back to the office. Finally, Kennard's heart started to frantically pound in his chest. Excited jitters exploded through his body when he was asked to join them in the back where the superintendent of Crater of Diamonds State Park waited for him. Kennard could barely breathe. Why was the small park called Crater of Diamonds? Because millions of years ago, volcanoes spewed lava all over the area. The discovery of diamonds had turned it into a mine, but there wasn't enough to make any significant profit. In the 1950s, the state took control and turned it into a tourist destination. Countless people, including Kennard, sifted through the dirt looking for precious gems. Most of the time they were worthless, just pretty stones that made for a good holiday story. However, the stunned banker had to sit down when they told him that he had not only found a valuable diamond, but he had also discovered the second largest one in the history of the park. Weighing in at 9 carats, the value ended up at $250,000. But Kennard didn't care. There was easily a small fortune in his future if he wanted to sell it, but that was the last thing on his mind. He thanked the workers and rushed to his bank to put it in the safety deposit box. His boss did have one burning question. "Are you going to quit?" Kennard answered with an adamant no. He was still young and wanted to work. For now, the hobby that had started in second grade and had finally paid off with a wealth of experience and memories was enough for now. He also had some advice for anyone who wants to explore like he did. Always have your finds checked. But more than that, he reminded people that it's not just about going to make money. Hobbies like these are all about having great moments with friends. This is why he has officially named his discovery the Kennard Friendship Diamond. Please share this with your friends and family.